So this is Acheron MP. It's a first fifth generation missile in service today in the world. It is presented here in infantry configuration, but the same munition can be used from turret and for the cavalry. It is a very flexible, very powerful weapon, and I will present you on a scenario all the its operational capabilities that can be applicable for the infantry but also for the cavalry. So in this scenario we are in middle of Europe. We are on the left a small village, and the Acheron unit has to prepare to neutralize the forces, the enemy forces within the village on the surroundings, to prepare an assault by other forces. The Acheron units are divided in two groups. One group will operate from behind the hill to neutralize forces within the village. And to do that, they will work with the Acheron system and also with small drones that will scout over the village and detect the enemy. On the southern part of the village, we have VBCI with T-40, an armored vehicle, with Acheron on turret, but also infantry forces. And one of the infantry group has been deployed on top of the hill to observe movement of the enemy in the south part and block potential reinforcements. During this observation time, the vehicle, the VBCI T-40, remains hidden from the enemy for stealthiness. For the observation, the Acheron can use either its infrared sensors from the firing post or its television sensor. You can shift from one band to another or even fuse the images to detect targets under camouflage. In this sentence, we have detected a first enemy, an artillery unit, that we can neutralize thanks to the zonal effect, the anti-personnel effect we have with the Acheron system. We are using the accurate vision of the firing post to precisely aim onto the target, which is up to 4 kilometers, and prepare the firing. Vas-y. The preparation of the firing of the munition is done completely automatically. So it's very simple. The gunner adjusts to position the center of the camera onto the target. And when the munition has been switched on, the missile knows exactly what is the target to be destroyed. And we have an automatic locking system onto the target. Now we see here the video from the missile. The missile has a camera in front of it. Either we have two bands, visible or infrared. And what is the key characteristic of this system is that all these videos can be downstream to the gunner thanks to a fiber optic. So we can have the gunner can have full control of the mission, full supervision of the mission, even during the flight of the missile. And it can change the target in flight by moving a black crosshair with a small joystick. And when you want to change the target, it simply has to click and the system will change the target automatically. During the mission, all the videos can also be shared with the team leader. A group of anti-tank is already operating in pairs of two, a gunner and a team leader. So with this weapon terminal, the team leader has an exact vision of what is happening and can work in it as a team with the gunner. In this example, the team leader says, okay, I validate the target, we will fire against the artillery unit as the first step to neutralize the enemy defense. And during the flight of the missile, we can detect a more valuable, a more critical target, a tank. So the gunner received the order to change the target, and during the flight of the missile, we have been able to lock onto the target, change the target, and optimize the aiming point. So now, the first target has been neutralized, so we can prepare a new sequence to neutralize the artillery unit. So we operate in a simple manner, and the task of the operator is very minimized by the fact that everything is automated in the Acheron system. Following this attack, the enemy will react and will start sending his column of tanks for the reinforcement of the defense of the village. So now the gunner has detected the arrival of the tanks. At this moment, the VBCI T-40 is leaving its position and comes into its combat position. And you have to imagine that you have a group of two. You have the fighting vehicle and the infantry and the infantry system working together. So the first tank, we will have to with the infantry to neutralize the first tank. We lock on it and we'll fire in fire and forget mode. So we are locked on it. Now we let the missile continue its mission solely to allow the gunner to engage very quickly a second target. So you will see we have started engagement of the second target. And you will see, so the first target has been neutralized by the missile in poorly fire and forget mode, and the second one, we keep control of it. And at the same time, the armored vehicle can perform exactly the same by a salvo firing, neutralizing the two last tanks. Once done, the armored vehicle is going back into its hidden position, and the infantry can slightly change position and start again its observation function. Mission has been successfully completed at the southern part of the village. Now we have also the other units which has for mission to neutralize forces within the village. I said this unit operates from behind a hill, so it's not detectable at all by the enemy. To detect the enemy, the two Acheron MP people are helped by a drone operator, and all videos and information from the drone are sent automatically to the weapon terminal of the Acheron system. And thanks to this information, we can scout around the villages and detect a target in the middle of the village. So this is typically the valuable target. The team leader validates the engagement. So at this moment, the drone operator is putting the tank in the middle of the screen of the drone. And thanks to this information, we have the position of the target. So the distance between the Acheron system and the target, and also the direction. Direction is indicated in the screen of the Acheron. And we have also the distance, so that we can compute automatically the trajectory to reach the target. This trajectory will be followed by the missile automatically without need of operator. And the camera of the target is put in the direction of the target. So when we start the firing, at the beginning we are behind the hill, so we don't see the target, so we see nothing. But with the trajectory forming of the missile, we are in ideal position then to look at the right area on the village to find the target. And then by simple click onto the target, we can validate it and neutralize it. And all this can be done safely as the crew is operating from behind the hill, is not detectable. All that can be done with the infantry, but also with the cavalry systems. So with weld systems, you have a very flexible ways of operation so that you can provide unique today fighting capability on which are capabilities which are needed in modern conflicts like we see today in Ukraine.